Hello and welcome back to A Splash of Paint, where it's time for me to put the final finishing touches to today's Try Your Hand At flower project. This is nice and dry. We're going to work dry on the paper now by painting a nice detailed flower and a butterfly sat on the top. The first thing I want to do is painting the actual main colour of the flower. For this, I want to use a size 6 brush and some intense violet mixed with a little bit of natural blue. Now the blue's got a bit of yellow in it. I'm just going to give it a bit of a clean. I don't want to contaminate it too much because the yellow will make it go more grey. So we'll avoid that if we can. There we go. This is a nice colour for bluebell woods too, the violet with the blue. And I want to do a bit of an outline to this. I'm going to start off by putting the actual petals that hang down. That's my first job. But I can do it in a way where I'm not completely painting the whole thing in. It's just getting the impression on and the shape of it more than anything at this stage. And then I'll go up and I'll be quite spotty and a bit spiky as we go around the top of the flower. And then clean brush, dab it on this piece of tissue which looks like it was found hanging from a tree, to be honest. Just give it a clean, make sure you use a clean bit of the tissue, and then just use the water to pull it all into the center. So that's one of the great things about watercolour, because the background colour comes through as well, which is giving a nice tonal variation. Just get a bit more water on the brush. I'm just going to add a few more flicks to these edges. They're quite spiky, the flowers, so they want to be quite randomly painted on that edge, on that top edge. There we go. Okay, now I've got a square brush there, chisel brush. This is a 1/4 inch or a 6mm one. Clean it, give it a bit of a squeeze, and then use that and put some highlights in. So on the tops of some of these petals, it's lifting off a little bit of colour. It's easy to do this while the paper's damp, while the area's damp. And because the violet is quite a strong colour, if you're not careful, it will stain your paper. So if you do it while it's damp, it comes off that little bit easier, creating that little bit of extra texture. There we go. And then back to the same colour again. There's a bit left over there from before, which is slightly heavier, which is good. Wipe it on the tissue. And then I'm just going to add some flicks inside the area. It's one of those times where I think we need to turn the board over. And then even just pulling that little bit of extra tonal work down to these areas. There we go. Okay, now I will come back at the end and just add a little bit of seeds and things to that area, but that's the basic scabious shape. Using a dark green, make sure I'm lemon yellow, natural blue, a little bit of crimson, just to darken it. It's almost a grey green. We can go right in underneath those bottom petals and painting the nice pointy leaves where the bud has broken open. Now this is quite dark, it wants to be dark because it would be in shadow. And then we come down the actual stem. But I'm only going to go so far with the dark and then I'll stop and I will just do one half of the stem in darkness. Then I'll clean the brush and I'll use lemon yellow pretty much by itself, just a little tiny bit of blue just to give me a lighter side to this. and I will drag it out of the dark. Even get a bit of water for an extreme light edge. There we go. It's always nice to use a bit of that lemon yellow just to tidy up some of these tips. And just make sure that they're nice and pointy, that kind of thing. Even add a couple of lighter ones that are catching a bit of sunlight or something. Get a little bit of water on the brush so I can just pull these back into the flower so they look as though they are actually part of it. A little bit of tidying up is quite nice though. It just gives an extra boost in colour. Now I've got the rigger brush and use some natural grey by itself. You get quite a lot of little dark seeds on these flowers. Just put a few little taps just randomly around. And then even just a few sort of stamens, just working up from the edge. I'm just using a bit of grey and just pulling in one or two dark areas. A few spots. They always make a nice bit of detail, they do. There we go, so that's pretty much the flower. I'm just going to put the butterfly sat on the top. And for this, using browns, I've got some browns from before. This one is actually a mixture of burnt sienna and a little bit of natural grey. I could use that for doing the outline of the actual butterfly itself. Now this is literally an outline to start with. Quite a ruffled back wing, you quite often see those. That one comes down. There's three wings in total on this one. Obviously there's four, but we're only seeing the three from this side. The background colour is a nice colour for this kind of natural coloured butterfly there. So using the water on the brush, we're just going to pull all this in. So basically just giving it a nice blend and a nice soften. So that's the basic shape, and in a few moments I'll put some separation and a bit of detail on there as well. But while that's drying off, I'll just put in the body, which is like a caterpillar. It's just what it is. It's just like a basic cigar shape. A slightly darker version of the same colour will do for this. Grey burnt sienna. And we've just got that coming through. Let's put a bit more grey in there, I think. That's natural grey. And again, you can almost just do the outline, put the head on. Clean brush, wipe it on tissue, and just use that water just to give it a bit of a soften in there. Now, I'm sure that people's going to go into an argument on how many legs these things have, but you're not going to see them because they're obviously tucked conveniently in the flower. Let's use some natural grey added to that same brown to create separation of wings. So the first one needs to come around this area. Clean brush, tissue, and then just soften away. So you can see already you've created that separation. There's one more just coming above. Clean brush, tissue. Just give it a soften. And then really just adding little bits of detail to it. So I've got some burnt sienna there. Adding little bits of detail. Let's make the colour slightly heavier. So just sort of random patterns. Obviously, you could be as precise as you like on this. You could use the internet for reference to get material from for doing this kind of work. Just want to put a bit of a winged pattern around those areas. You've got the nice little spot on the wing there. Just pulling one or two lines coming back out from that corner. And then using a rigger brush, let's get some nice detail. Just use natural grey for the detail. If you twist the end of your brush over the tissue, you get that nice point. And then we can put the famous little, just put a couple of little antennas on there, if that's what they're called. And you get that little bit of a legs and things coming down. So that was quite nice there. It's given quite a nice effect for the butterfly there. A little bit of water just to blend in any hard lines that you're not happy with. And then really for me, the finishing touch to this picture would be choose a little bit of opaque white or some gouache just to squirt into your palette. Use it fresh. Don't use white paint that's been there a long time because it doesn't give you the opacity. A little bit of water, not too much because it dilutes it too much and it disappears. And then just put a few kind of white spots around the top of the flower and even that little bit of highlight just on some of the corners to create transparency in the wings. Let's get the water tissue and then I'm going to soften that white into it. Just let it disappear. When it dries, it completely changes colour. So it's best to see the dry version at the end because it does always look different when it dries. I think we can say we've created quite a nice little wilderness flower scene there, folks. So there you go, folks, a nice little watercolour project for you to try at home. Right, time for our final break, but join us in part four when leading wildlife artist Pip McGarry shows us why he's wild about oils in our animal magic art bike feature. See you soon.